The first colors we're going to touch on are the primary colors. Blue, red, and yellow. Every color in this universe, world, planet, spinning, floating rock is made up of these three colors. These cannot be created. They just are. If you wanted to paint, well, look, when I grew up, we were really poor. We always had the three primaries because you could make any color with these primaries. It's gonna take a little bit longer. Would it be nicer to just go to the Walmart and get a purple? Yes. But you can get a purple by mixing blue and red together. Blue is your darkest primary. Right here, blue. This is your black hair color, dark browns. Is made of mostly blue. Any hair color that has majority of blue in it is going to be considered a cool color. Think of like a beautiful mountainscape, the blues, the greens. Those are cool colors. Your hair can either be cool, warm, or neutral. For example, my hair is warm. It has an orange tint to it. I'm not a fan of it, but I'm taking a break from hair color. It just is what it is. If I wanted to change that warm tone, I do the opposite of warm, and warm tones are oranges, fiery sunset. So the opposite of hot is cold, ice, blue, snow. If I wanted to change my warm tones, I would use something on this side of the color wheel, the cooler tones. Your next primary is red. It is the middle primary. This is going to be your medium auburn browns. Red, fire, it's a warm tone. It's the opposite of blue. Yellow is your lightest primary. This is going to be your blondes. Yellow is also going to be a warm tone. If you mix all three of these together in equal proportions, you're going to either get black, brown, or a muddy-ish kind of gray. You may remember this from art class. You mix it all together and you get a terrible color. It's usually like a, it looks like swamp water. Not swamp water, but what's the slime or sludge under the swamp where you put your foot in it? That. It's like a grayish, brownish, weird color. Murky. But if you mix one part blue with two parts red with three parts yellow, you get what we call a natural or neutral brown. It's not a dominant cool tone and it's not a dominant warm tone. It's just in the middle. It's neutral or natural. When you're at Sally's and you're at the color wall and it's really overwhelming, there's lots of different brands, lots of boxes. They all have different numbers, 6RB, 2N, 5RR, 6RVR. It can be a little overwhelming. Every color line is gonna have an N series. Looks like this. This one is 5N. Is that the right side? Yes, 5N. The first number means it's a level 5, pretty similar to my root color. The second letter represents the tonality. N stands for natural or neutral. So it's saying one part blue, two parts red, three parts yellow gets brown. How they lighten and darken the shades are with black and white. Black makes it darker, white makes it lighter. So a 5N is a neutral base. Again, there's no dominance of red and there's no dominance of blue. If you wanted to make it have a red tone, you're gonna add more red or perhaps get something like a 5R. Back to our three primaries. If you mix two primaries together, you're going to get a secondary color. It's like they have a baby. So yellow and red mate, have a baby. It's orange. Equal parts of red, equal parts of yellow give you orange. Meep. Equal parts of blue, equal parts of yellow give you green. Equal parts of blue, equal parts of red give you violet. In hair color, we always refer to purple as violet. So you're not gonna see 5P for 5 purple. You're going to see 5V, 5 violet. Kind of how we say lightener for bleach. It's a less harsh term to be using in front of a client. It sounds nicer to say something like, I'm gonna put a violet base color to tone out your blonde today. Versus, I'm gonna throw some purple on there to get rid of that cat piss yellow in the sink. So anyway, when you're at Sally's, you're never really gonna see the word purple. It's going to be violet. We're not gonna get much into tertiary colors, but that's when you mix a primary, and a secondary. Boop. It would be yellow, orange. The primary is always listed first. It's like king of the castle. It's the biggest and baddest one. Yellow, orange, yellow, green, blue, violet, red, orange. Complementary colors are colors that are across from each other on the color wheel. This is going to solve all your tonality issues. If I have yellow hair and want to get rid of it, I'm going to take its complementary color, which is violet. When yellow and violet meet in the middle, they cancel or neutralize each other out. This is how violet-based shampoo is working. The purple shampoo, shimmer lights, I can't think of any other brands right now. Shimmer lights, purple shampoo. If you have yellow hair and you put purple over it, the purple-based shampoo, it helps tone it out. Purple shampoo is a temporary hair color. It's not going to make much change. If you really have cat pee yellow hair, you're going to need an actual hair color, a toner. Hair color with developer. Purple shampoo is just kind of a maintenance thing to refresh your blonde. Use it once or twice a week. Orange hair, how to get rid of that? Across from orange is blue. So that tells me that I need to put something with blue in my formula to cancel out this orange tone that's showing up. If you have yellow and orange hair, which is pretty common when you're bleaching, you're going to use something with violet and blue. One of my favorite hair colors is by Pravana, 8.22, which translates to 8BV, level 8 blue violet. It does not mean when you pour it out of the tube, it's straight blue and violet hair color. The hair color is saying I'm still a combination of the three primaries to get a nice even neutral brown. But I've also got violet tones in there and I've also got blue tones in there. But at my core, I'm still an actual hair color. The brown. All our hair colors are stemming from a combination of our three primaries. How we're getting all these hundreds of different colors is by adding in a combination of more primaries or secondary colors. Another pretty hair color is like a 5R. Level 5. Level meaning how light or dark is it? That's about my hair color. Level 5, it's still got a brown base to it. It just has extra red. More red. So it's going to be a level 5, think of this root area, still have a brown base, but instead of maybe two reds, maybe I have three to make it extra red. It's gonna be a warm hair color. If I want straight up fantasy color red, that's just pure red pigment. They're usually temporary, semi-permanent colors. So if you're just wanting straight up red, straight up fire engine red, you can do that. But your canvas, your hair, needs to be at a very light level. You need to get it up to this yellow, this primary, light blonde. So that way, when you put red over it, it's gonna cover it up. You can't start with a dark color. Remember, darker colors, blacks, they have a blue base, the darkest primary. If you put red over this, you can see it kind of turns purple because blue and red make purple, but it doesn't show up red. Blue is the darkest. It will always override everything. It will always turn it darker. So if you want to get a fantasy color like red, green, whatever, you have to get your hair to that yellow primary. You have to get it blonder, which is done by bleaching, lightening. Almost forgot. Another common one is green hair. People get green hair from swimming in chlorine pools, from making a color mistake, a lot of darker hair colors if you don't use a filler. And all a filler is it gives the hair something to grab onto. When we color our hair, again, we're working with the three primaries. If you take yellow hair, which is blonde, take it right here, blue, darker, let's say a level 3 or 4, which is a little bit darker than this. You're missing a major component. You're missing a primary. You have to have all three of these in some sort of combination. If you don't include all three, it's going to show up in the results. For example, again, you have yellow hair, blonde hair. You want to go darker, level 3, level 4, dark brown. So you went from yellow to blue. You missed your girl red over here. So what happens? If you miss a primary, you get the opposite result, which is green. That's why a lot of times you'll see people who go darker, they have a green, murky tint to their hair. You missed a primary. So you have to fill your hair, which is just adding that primary in, putting red on it first, and then going back in with your color formulation. So that red will stick out there. It's not gonna turn your hair red. It's just gonna take into account that I'm adding all three of these in a combination to get a brown color. Quick little recap. Three primaries to make up all colors. Blue, red, and yellow are making up all the colors we see with these eyeballs. It's just the combination of them that make up different colors. When you mix two neighboring primaries together, you get a secondary color. For example, red and yellow create orange. If I make a mistake, my hair is yellow. I'm gonna take my color wheel and look across from yellow. That's violet, purple. I need something with purple to correct, excuse me, English is hard, correct the yellow. So if I bleach my hair and oh shoot, it's yellow, your toner needs to have purple in it to cancel out yellow. A lot of information, but it's gonna make sense when we start getting more in depth into hair coloring, especially with fillers and toners. If you have any questions, let me know. Comments, complaints, I guess. Go ahead, why not? I'm here for you on this channel every single week, and don't forget to check out my main channel. I'll link it below. I'm here for you every single Sunday. Almost forgot, on that channel, the entertainment channel.